It's lovely to see you all here today, and if you're worshipping with us, you're very welcome. And if you're joining us online from wherever you are in the world, we welcome you too and hope you enjoy worship and fellowship with us today. Thank you to the band for that lovely start. And we're in for a really good programme today. It's lovely to see you all, as I say, but it's especially lovely to see Captain Jeffrey Ambitan, all the way from Indonesia. I think he's coming to suss us out because he and the family are moving over in July when Leo and Eva go back to Indonesia. So we're hoping, really hoping, that you might feel that you might like to join us here at Croydon. You'll be very welcome. Thank you. It's good to see you now. During this week, Home League will meet on Wednesday, and Anne Fincham is a special guest, and she's going to talk about, or give us a lecture on, red peppers or green tomatoes. I haven't a clue, so you will have to come and find out at 10:30 on Wednesday. Everybody is welcome, young, old, male, female, whoever. Please do come and find out all about Anne's red peppers or green tomatoes. At the same time on Wednesday, also in the community hall, there will be the foot clinic, and that will be running from 10 a.m. A bit further on, the middle of next week, Wednesday the 24th of April and Thursday the 25th of April, we have an SPNS roadshow when they come, and people from around the division and people from here can come and buy things that they need. It is usually better to order ahead if you can, so you know it'll be here, because they don't carry a lot of stock, but they will have some bits and pieces. So that'll be Wednesday between 2:30 and 8 p.m. and then Thursday, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. That next weekend, there will be Youth Band and Chorus Taster Day, or afternoon, on Sunday the 28th of April. The details are in the call bulletin, so, and there is a link in there for you to book a place online. Please do come if you can, if you're youthful enough. I think it's between 16 and 30, or maybe even a bit younger than that. But do come. It's always been great fun to be in a divisional youth chorus or youth band. And hopefully, this new one in our division will take off and we'll go wonderful places. Next Sunday, Major Ian Woodgate will be leading us in worship. And that will be at 10 o'clock here. Back to today, after this meeting, there will be refreshments in the community centre. And along with these beautiful flowers, there are some refreshments left over from Peggy's fantastically wonderful Memorial Day on Friday. We had such a good time remembering her. Beautiful flowers left over from the funeral and some lovely eats as well. So please do come and help us finish those. There will be an open air, as far as I'm aware. I haven't been told not. So I'll consult with the band afterwards and just give you a proper update then. So behind me today, we have Major Meaghan Gallagher. When she starts talking, you will know she's not from here either. But we've borrowed her on a long-term lease. And she will be going back to her homeland in Australia in a few days' time for some furlough. But she will come back. And currently she works as the Undersecretary for the South Pacific and East Asia Territory. It's a big, long word, that. But we're so grateful that she's taken the time to prepare and speak to us and lead us in worship today. And I'm going to hand over to her now. And please welcome Major Gallagher.
Well, it's a joy to be able to share with you today. And you all know I'm Australian, don't you? Not that you can't tell by my accent. And I am actually going home in about just over a week, and I'm looking forward to spending time with my dad and my sister, and hopefully seeing the rest of the family. But you know, we are a family of God, and no matter where we are in the world, we are with family, and I am grateful for that. Psalm 136 in Psalms now says this: "Thank you, God, for all these things that reveal your love. Thank you for the heavens that cover us, for the earth beneath our feet, for the sun in the day and the stars in the night, for the snow and the rains, for mountains and valleys and trees and flowers. Thank you, God, for those people who demonstrate your love. Thank you for those great men and women who followed you throughout history, for the priests and prophets and apostles and ministers, for the doctors and teachers and mothers and fathers and painters and musicians and writers and farmers and labourers and clerks, for those men and women who gloried in your love and dedicated their lives in loving others. Thank you, God, for choosing me to be one of your people, for calling me and equipping me to communicate your love to the world around me. Thank you, God. I wonder whether that's your prayer today, that you're thanking God, that you have been called to be one of his people, that you have been called and equipped to communicate his love. And so we're going to sing together, O Church, Arise. And so I invite you to arise as we sing together this great song, O Church, Arise, and Put Your Armour On. Please be seated. When with Christ we stand in glory. We need to turn our eyes on Jesus to do that. And so I invite you to sing with me as we prepare ourselves for prayer. And Lieutenant Colonel John's going to come and pray a special prayer today for the Nunez family who are recently lost a member of their family quite suddenly and is a relative of Patricia's. And so I invite Colonel John to come and pray before we sing this song.
We have been reminded, of course, that it really doesn't matter where we come from. We're all part of one great family. And that is the great thing over which we rejoice today. Now, we have been asked to pray for the cousin of Patricia, way off in South America. But it doesn't matter where he is. God is there. And we're going to pray for him, who is very poorly at the moment, and for the family as well, that are so in miles distant from them. But all together, we pray that God will bless them and healing hands may come upon him, if that is God's will. Padre nuestro, te damos gracias en esta mañana porque tú estás aquí entre nosotros. Te agradecemos porque siempre tú nos conoces. Siempre sabes, estás consciente de nuestras necesidades. Y en este momento, ante ti, pedimos que tu mano de sanidad, tu mano de consuelo, tu mano de ayuda sea sobre Germán Núñez. Tú lo conoces, tú sabes su necesidad y pedimos que seas con él en toda la manera en que él necesita de tu ayuda. Pedimos también por la familia que tú seas con ellos, tan distantes, pero todos parte de la familia, todos en tus manos. Y en tus manos encomendamos a la familia en este momento. Sea con ellos, pues, te pedimos, en nombre de Cristo, nuestro Salvador. Amén.
Turn our eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. Let's sing together. Our Father, we come before you and we thank you for Jesus, which we only celebrated a couple of weeks ago, his death and resurrection, which means that we can be in relationship with you. And so we thank you for that. We thank you that we can come to you with any sort of request. We thank you that we can come to you with any of our pain, with any of our joy. And so, Father, we just ask for you to come and minister to our hearts this morning. We thank you that we can come to you in freedom. We don't have to hide away. And so we pray for our brothers and sisters in Christ who do have to do that. We pray for our brothers and sisters in Christ who are under persecution. And Father, we pray that you will give them a boldness. You would give them courage. That you would give them strength. to do what it is that they need to do for you in the situations that they find themselves in. Father, we are so grateful to spend time together today. And so as we come together, may we look to each other. May we find in each other your spirit burning brightly. And where someone needs to be encouraged, Father, give us the right words. Father, where some of us are hurting, Father, may they know they are surrounded with love. And Father, as we come and continue our worship, may it be worthy of you. May it glorify you. Because you are the one we have come to worship. And we pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. The songsters are going to come and bring their message to us today. So please continue in a state of worship as you listen to them. I don't know whether you're picking up yet what the theme of the meeting is. I wonder. We're going to sing again, and we're going to do a couple of things during singing this song. And I know we're very good at doing multiple things. Okay? So we're going to take up our collection while we sing the song. And then Nigel, I believe, will pray with us after the song is completed. So the song, soldiers of our God, arise. The day is drawing nearer. Shake the slumber from your eyes. The light is growing clearer. Do I make you stand for this song? Well, that was a resounding yes that I heard. So please be standing as we sing this song, with the offering being taken up as well. So let's sing this song through.
Hallelujah. Thank you very much for your giving this morning. Just a couple of verses from Ephesians. When you meet together, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs as you praise the Lord with all your heart. Always use the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to thank God the Father for everything, and so much does he give us. Let us pray. Father God, we come to you this morning. We thank you because you do give us so much. We thank you that from what you have given us, we have given back to you what is rightfully yours. And we pray, Lord, that for the many different things that we give to your service, whether it's time, talents, or financial, we pray, Lord, that you will use them wisely. We pray, Lord, that as we are given the opportunity to provide service to people within our community, we not only provide physical and mental health, but we also provide spiritual health to those people, and we give them a hunger to know more about you. We pray, Lord, that you will bless each person who has given this morning and all those that give in many other ways. We ask this in and through your precious name. Amen.
I'm going to invite John to come forward. And kids, we've got something for you. So do you want to come here?
That's great. Thank you so much for coming up. Because I'd look rather silly standing here by myself, wouldn't I? Hello. Great. The sound of my ear. That's lovely to see you all. Thank you very much indeed. Now then, who is good at doing... Who can count up to 10? Yes, can you count up to 10? I'm sure you can as well. Can you count up to 100? Yes. Okay. Can we have the first slide, please, Steve? That'd be great. Thank you. Maths can be fun. Who thinks maths are fun?
Yes!
It can be fun, believe me. Okay, thank you. Go on, Steve. Next slide, please. All right, what is 1 + 1?
2. Yes!
Oh, so good. Stuart, I'm going to need your help. All right, then, let's see. The next one's a bit harder. Can you see the next one? What is 1 + Oh, it deserves a clap, don't you think, really? Okay, next one, please. 1 + 99. It's gone. Yes, 100. Very good, thank you so much. Stuart, did you know that one?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Right. Just. All right, now the next slide. 1 + 2 + 3.
6.
Yes, good, good, good. Right. Now, Stuart, you know what's coming next, don't you? Next slide. Any offers? 1 + 2 + 3 + 4 + 5 + 6 up to 98. Obvious, isn't it? 4,851. A different question. The thing is, if you add 1 and 99 makes 100, 2 and 98 is 100, 3 and 97 is 100, 4 and 96 is 100. Okay? So you've got 48 hundredths, the one at the beginning, and the 50 in the middle. 4,851. It's easy, isn't it? There we are. Now, look around the hall here today. Who's good at counting? How many people are there here this morning? Have you counted everybody in the whole meeting? Don't you think?
Wait.
It'll take a while. I'll tell you what, there's somebody whose job it is to count. Sergeant Major, come and tell us how many people are here today, please.
99.
Ooh. Good, impressive. I'll tell you something very special. Everybody in this room looks at you and they all love you, they like you, and they pray for you, and they're so glad you're here. Every week they look forward to seeing you here. Now, one of the Sergeant Major's job every year is to count attendances for 2 months. Next slide, please, Stephen. And here we are. I've been collecting figures for 10 years now. So the first on the left is 2013. This is the average attendance each week, each Sunday morning. And you can see for the first 7 years, more or less the same. They've kept pretty steady numbers. Then what happened? We had the pandemic. And since then, numbers have been lower. And so there's the last 2 years, 2022, 2023. So we've had those are the average attendances for the last 2 years. And we look forward to finding out this year, because we're in the middle of our counting season just now, when we count up all the attendances during the week on Sundays, and we'd like to find out what's happening this year. So that's really quite important. I'll tell you one thing. We know there's 99 people here today. How many children are there in the whole world?
I'll tell you what, I don't know the answer to that one.
But somebody does. God knows every single child in the whole world. He knows them and loves them and cares for them. We'll come back to that in a minute. Okay then, next slide please. Now here's something interesting. That red line shows the average number of people who looked at our meetings last year, every week. Those 2 months that we counted up. So the average number of people looking at our online postings was 1,401. So when the Sergeant Major welcomes everybody here, they welcome you, we are also welcoming many, many people around the world. We get some messages from some of these people. Okay, some of them only looked in for 5 minutes, 10 minutes. They may have cut out something. Sermon. Who knows? I don't know. Sorry, Meaghan. But just remember that. Our witness is going out much, much more than numbers we have here. That's, I think it's just a fantastic thought. Now then, okay, thanks, Steve. Now here's a tricky question. I'm going to ask Stuart if he can solve the formula at the bottom. So y equals h times x tan alpha minus gx squared over 2b squared cos squared alpha. Okay, and it's obvious, you know, h is height, alpha is the angle, g is the acceleration due to gravity. Have you got it? Anybody else work it out? Oh, Rachel, your dad thinks you can do it. Do you think you could work that one out? I think you can, actually. What we've got here is a ball. I'm going to ask Stuart, just stand there. Right, can you catch this ball? Hooray, well done. You worked out that formula. Throw it back to him. Next person, can you catch it, do you think? Have a go. Yes, because the next slide, oh yes, next slide, thank you. That is the formula for the trajectory of the ball when it's thrown from one person to the next. Anybody else want to catch it? Yes. Hooray, you see, the human brain is fantastic, isn't it? You knew that formula all along because you can work out where to catch the ball when it's thrown to you. Go on. Yes. Brilliant. Thank you all so much for taking part. We are all, the next slide, thank you. This is what it says in the Psalm 139. We praise God, I praise you, because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. God's works are wonderful, and we know that full well. The human brain is the most complicated thing known in the universe, and it can calculate things that complicated formula for catching a ball. That's great. And one day, we will all learn to do that. That's great, thank you. Okay, next slide is very important. I said earlier about God knows every child. He knows every one of us. And so, thank you for taking part this morning. So we're going to see if you can catch something else. We've got some sweets here. So Stuart's going to throw you a sweet. When you've got your sweet, you can go downstairs They can go out to Sunday school, okay? Hundreds of thousands.
Come on, tell me, who really knew the formula? I'm guessing by that giggle, no one. We're going to listen to the band as they continue to lead us in worship, and they're going to play Stand Up for Jesus. Lieutenant Leo Siwi is going to come and read our scripture for us this morning.
The Bible reading is taken from Ephesians 6. God. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God, so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the power of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything to stand. Stand firm, then, with the belt of truth buckled up, buckled around your waist with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fit with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and pray in the Spirit on all occasion with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. Amen.
Let's share in a prayer together. Father, we come before you and we come to look at your word and to look at what it says to us today. And we pray that you will be with us, give us an open heart and an open mind to what it is you have for us today. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I wonder what comes to your mind when you think of armour and the armour of God particularly. Do you think of a knight in all its silver from head to toe? Do you think of maybe soldiers going to battle or some battle of some type? Well, when we look at the passage that Leo just read, there are particular items that we as Christians should have. The belt of truth, the breastplate, I can't say that word, the breastplate of righteousness, feet ready with the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, the sword of the Spirit, and prayer. Now, if we've got this image in our mind, sometimes I don't think that particularly has helped me. So I've got some things here that may help us remember. So what was the first one? The belt. Here is a belt. What was next? Some people are listening, some people are not. So this covers the front and the back when it's worn. So that's our breastplate. What was next? No, not helmet. The shoes. Oh, good shoes. That means we need good shoes. What's next? Shield of faith. Well, I don't have a shield, right? So I did think I have an umbrella. And it shields me from the rain. So, I won't put it up completely. So that's the shield. Then what? Helmet of salvation. I don't have a helmet. I do have a cap. And then? Sword of the Spirit. I have the Bible app on my phone. So that's my sword. Everyday items that we can remember to put on the armour of God. But let's have a look what it tells us more in depth. In verse 14, it says that we find the belt of truth needs to be buckled around our waist and the breastplate of righteousness in place. So it's a belt of truth. But what is truth? When looking up the definition of truth, we look up the word true. We find that to be true is to be in accordance with facts. Faithful, exact, correct, genuine, real, sincere. The state of being true is something that is true, accustomed to speaking the truth, accurate, unwaveringly, or staunchly loyal. God desires us to be faithful and unswervingly loyal to him. When we decide to follow Jesus, our old self is gone and the new self has come. The truth of his word is indicated by the life of Jesus and his example that we can follow. When we accept him, his righteousness is given to us. So what is righteousness? To be righteous is to be just, to be upright, to be godly, to be good, to be honest. We need to accept Jesus for God to see us as righteous. For example, if we were looking at the world through a red lens, everything would appear red. If we looked at everything through a blue glass, everything would appear blue. If we look through yellow, everything would appear yellow, and so on and so on. So when we believe in Jesus as our Saviour, God looks at us through Jesus. He sees us in the holiness of his Son. Our sins are attributed to Jesus and his righteousness to us. So this means that we should endeavour to be like Jesus. Verse 15, we read about our feet needing to be ready with the gospel. Just as we would put on our shoes, we go walking in our shoes, do we not? We go out into the world with our shoes, do we not? So we should be ready to go and to be prepared to speak about Jesus. Some of us do that automatically, every day. Others of us do it in a little bit different way. We may cook a meal for a neighbour. We may visit others. It's not up front, not like me preaching here today. It's those acts of service that are showing the good news. We need to be ready to talk about Jesus and the gospel of peace, our boots of peace, our shoes of peace, helps us to be ready. Does this mean that we are going to be perfect all the time? Well, I just need to tell you right now, I am not perfect. I don't know about you. And I am glad that I have Jesus as my Saviour that helps me to be better than who I am without him. Our aim should be to live as Jesus lived, to be in a loving relationship with God and with others, not living for ourselves. There's a little poem that I found that says this: you are writing a gospel, a chapter each day, by deeds that you do, by words that you say. Men read what you write, whether faithless or true. What is the gospel according to you? Verse 16 talks about our shield of faith. So what does a shield do? A shield protects a soldier from attack. In our particular circumstance, we are looking at shielding from the attacks of the devil. He knows our weak spots and what will get us to stray from living the way that God wants us to. He tries to sway us away from what God wants us to be like. When we have faith in something, we believe in it. Faith has been described as a gift of God. So is the air, but we have to breathe it. So is bread, but we have to eat it. So is water, but we have to drink it. So how do we accept this gift? Not by a feeling, for faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, which we find in Romans 10, 17. It is not for us to sit down and wait for faith to come to us in some kind of feeling. Rather, faith comes when we take God at his word. So we should take God at his word and have faith, believing that he will shield us from the attacks of the devil. Verse 17, we read about the helmet of salvation and the sword of truth. Sorry, the sword of the Spirit. The helmet, when it's put on, protects the head. Head, brain, knowledge. Knowledge of God gives us an understanding of salvation. We can attain and store knowledge in our heads. We can therefore know that we are saved. This head knowledge, though, doesn't need to translate to heart knowledge, but it should translate to heart knowledge as well as head. We need to allow it to go from the head to the heart. In Colossians 3:9, we read about having our old self being taken off and a new self being put on, being renewed in the knowledge of the image of its creator. There's a common story known about Martin Luther. And it's said that the devil approached Luther and tried to use the fact that every person is fallible. He presented Martin Luther with a long list of sins that he was guilty of. And when he'd finished, Luther simply said, "Think a little harder, you may have forgotten some." So the devil added some more to the list. And at the conclusion of this exchange, Martin Luther simply said, "That's fine. Now write across the list in red ink, the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin." There was nothing that the devil could say. We therefore should use our knowledge to know our salvation and to understand more about our salvation. That is, we have been saved by what Jesus did on the cross. Question to you this morning is, do you know that you are saved? Well, the sword of the Spirit is the word of God. We need to study this and apply it to our lives. For us to succeed in our Christian life, we need to know the Bible. We should study it, remember verses from it, so that there is a comeback that we can have to the devil when he starts to attack us. I don't know about you, but when I practically apply what I learn, it seems to stick a bit better. But that means I need to study the word. How else are we going to find out how to live? We can't just leave it up to others, but to look out for ourselves. It's a bit like an explorer and a tourist. A tourist travels quickly, stopping only to observe the high, noticeable and publicised points of interest. An explorer, on the other hand, takes his time to search out all that he can find. Too many of us read the Bible like a tourist, just flicking through, trying to find an appropriate verse. and then complain that our devotional times are really fruitless. We need to take more time and be an explorer. Explorer of the Bible. Getting into those nooks and crannies that appear when we get beneath the surface. So how are we with the study of our Bibles? And does this need a little bit more attention? And then finally, in verse 18, we are reminded that we are to pray on all occasions. On all occasions. In looking at prayer, we should say that it is what fastens all the pieces together of our armour. No matter what happens to us in our lives, whether good or bad, we should be praying. We are not promised an easy life as a Christian. So there will be good things, exciting things, bad things, even disastrous things that happen to us. However, praying can help. We should remember the verse from Philippians 4, verse 6. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. I think it's important to note that it doesn't say for everything, it says in everything. No matter what is happening in our lives and in the lives of those around us, we need to pray. Leonard Ravenhill has said that the church has many organisers, but few agonisers. Many who pay, but few who pray. Many resters, but few wrestlers. Many who are enterprising, but few who are interceding. People who are not praying and praying. The secret of praying is praying in secret. A worldly Christian will stop praying, and a praying Christian will stop worldliness. Tithes may build a church, but tears will give it life. In the matter of effective praying, there have so many left, but so much to so few. So I wonder today, how is your prayer life? Are we clothed in the full armour of God? That is, are we suited up? Are we suited up with truth? Have you got your belt on? Are we suited up with righteousness? Do you have your breastplate on? Are you suited up with the gospel of peace? Do you have your boots on? Are you suited up with faith? Have you got your shield? Are you suited up with salvation? Have you got your helmet on? The word of God, have you got it with you? Are you delving into it? And do you pray? Is one of these facets in the armour a little less effective in your life? In other words, is there a chink in your armour? Well, we can rectify the chink today. We've got an opportunity to rectify it. We've been talking about particular things that relate to Christians this morning. And I don't know whether someone here doesn't know Jesus, but today might be an opportunity for you to come to know him. for those of us that have been Christians for a while now, is there a chink that stands out to you that you need to rectify? And so we're going to sing how wonderful it is to walk with God. And as we sing this song together, the place of prayer is open for you to come to. If you want someone to come and pray with you, just ask for that. How wonderful it is to walk with God. And so we'll sing this song straight through, and I invite you to respond to what God is requesting of you. Father, we come before you and we thank you for the reminder today that we are to put on the full armor of God, not just bits and pieces, but put it on fully. May we be reminded this week as we put on our clothes, may we be reminded this week when we search your word, when we explore your word, that we are to put on the full armour of God so that we can be effective children for you. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, we can't have had a meeting about the armour of God without being God's soldiers. And so we're going to sing that song, God's Soldiers March as to War, a soldier on an alien shore. I'm having trouble with my words today. I don't know whether you've picked that up. So we're going to sing this song. There's only two verses, so it's going to be quick. And the band's going to help us. So depending on how quickly they play it, we may be quicker. Bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you each his peace. Amen.